Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you're all doing very well. So I just watched Yasuke on Netflix. Let's talk about it. So Yasuke is a Netflix anime series that is centered on the famous black samurai. Yes, there was a black samurai in real life, okay, in real history, who lived in Japan circa the 16th century, as I understand it. Now, he was originally from a region that would be a modern day Mozambique, and he came to Japan, I believe, through like the merchant trading routes, and he was able to gain favor from some very important like lords in Japan, and he became a black samurai, a very distinguished kind of title to hold in Japanese lore and history. And this is just such an incredible story. When I heard this, when I heard about this black samurai, and when I heard that Netflix was going to make a series about this, I was like, count me in. Count, like, where and when do I need to be there? I will absolutely be there, because of course, are you kidding me? Now listen, when it comes to me and anime, it's a difficult relationship, okay? I personally have never really gotten into that genre, but I know it's become incredibly popular within the black community all around the world, to the point where we're starting to see a little bit more representation of people of color within anime that is produced in Japan, which is absolutely incredible, considering that Japan is largely a homogenous population, so they tend to only represent themselves. Like, it makes sense, like, their population is like 99.9% them, so it makes sense that they would represent themselves. That figure isn't accurate, by the way, just to make note of that. I do have a cousin in Japan, but whatever. But of course, considering the global appeal of anime and considering just how diverse the audience has become for this genre, it makes sense that they're starting to introduce some diversity on screen as well, which is really exciting. But to have a series that is based off of the black samurai, like, that is just something else. That's why I leapt on, okay? That's why I had to jump in there, because even though I'm sure some anime connoisseurs would say, like, this is not the best series to delve into this genre with, the subject matter itself, like, I'm sorry, but it had me intrigued, okay? And I have to say, overall, like, I had a fun time with this series, but unfortunately there were a lot of missed opportunities here, and we'll delve into my thoughts on all of that. But first of all, of course, if you haven't already, please be sure to subscribe to my channel and make sure you turn on your notifications so that you can be told when I upload next. Now, without further ado, let's delve into my thoughts on Yasuke. So first off, before we delve into my critiques of the series, let's start off with the good, okay? We already know when it comes to anime that we're going to be getting some spectacular visuals, because that's just how it's done over there, okay? That's just how it's done within this genre. Some of the visuals in this series are just disgustingly breathtaking. Like, how dare you give me such a beautifully, aesthetically pleasing show? Like, ugh, it's just stunning. You can see the art form, you can see the artwork, the dedication in some of these scenes. It's just absolutely breathtaking. And this series also has quite a few anime tropes that you can see throughout. Even from someone who, you know, doesn't watch a lot of anime at all, like, whatsoever, I could spot the anime tropes that we see here. I mean, the monsters looking extra monstrous, looking extra horrifying, the idea of, like, the human form breaking apart and tearing apart and to reveal something horrific and something gruesome and disgusting. And of course you have this kind of juxtaposition between the horror, the gruesomeness of some of these monsters and these action sequences, you know, juxtaposed against the beauty, the elegance, the art form of some of these picturesque scenes. Like, that is an anime staple. And also, to this show's credit, I will say that it does a very good job of addressing the fact that Yasuke is a black samurai. First of all, the fact that he's like a black guy in like 16th century Japan to begin with, okay, everyone remarks upon that. You do have this moment where this lord, this very important person, says that he deserves to be washed after saving this child. And then they just keep washing him and they're like, hold up. hold up, like, is his skin just like that? What's going on here? It's this kind of perplexity surrounding his skin tone because they've never seen someone like him. So I do enjoy the fact that it very much directly addresses that, and also the added impact of him being a black samurai and his time, you know, during those adventures, you know, people very much looking down on him, saying that he will always be a servant no matter what, you know, no matter what he accomplishes, no matter what his skill level is, because he is black and because he is a foreigner, that's how some people will always see him. And on top of this, I will also say that I did enjoy the character of Yasuke, or Yasan, he goes by many names throughout this series. I did very much enjoy him overall. I have some qualms, which I'll get into literally within moments, but overall I did find him to be a very compelling character, a pretty charismatic character when he wanted to be, like when he lightened up a little bit, but even when he was very serious, he did have that sense of, you know, respect and honor and dignity to him. And then even when we do get introduced to the character where he's kind of at a low point because of the traumas of his past, we do still see that that warrior, that skillful, you know, very well trained, very well respected warrior is still bubbling underneath the surface. He just needs to be presented with an opportunity to showcase that, and that's what the adventures of this series present him with. So I do very much enjoy the character of Yasuke. It's just that overall I was slightly disappointed with the way that they used this character. I think there were a lot of wasted opportunities with this series. I still enjoyed the show that I ended up getting, but it could have been so much better. And what it really comes down to, one of my biggest qualms when it comes to this series, is why the hell would you create a series that is based off of a black samurai and make the whole story about something completely completely irrelevant? We meet this character when he's no longer a samurai. We follow him on his journey when he's no longer a samurai. Why? Why? And then we get these flashbacks to the times when he was a samurai doing these incredible things, fighting these incredible battles, and they're just flashbacks. Like, we don't actually get to see that play out, at least until the very end, in the present day, and he's not a samurai or a proper samurai at that point. Why would you focus the story on such a weird part of this character's journey? Like, that makes no sense to me. This is something that could have been done in like season 2, when we already know the character, when, you know, we've already been introduced to his exploits as a samurai. We can then go into season 2 where some time has passed and he's become disillusioned with the idea and his past and everything. He's suffering from traumas, and then we get to see him pick up right where we left off in season 1, where this time around he has to take care of this girl who has special powers. We'll talk about her in a second. And then that's where the story could have continued in a separate season. It should have never started off this first season that we've gotten with this character, with an adventure that had absolutely nothing to do with him being a samurai, being a black samurai. What I wanted to see was the story of how he became a black samurai. Seeing him be trained, seeing him face adversity because he's black, and, you know, people looking down on him. We got some of that, but again, they were in flashbacks. I wanted to see it happen, you know, in real time. I wanted that to be the story of the series. And you can incorporate the typical, you know, anime isms, the monsters, you know, the terrifying visuals if you want to. The violence definitely could have been there still, but we would have been following the story of this guy becoming a black samurai. But instead, no, it's told through flashbacks. What a wasted opportunity. I cannot believe. Oh, like, no offense to LaShawn Thomas, who created this series, but how could you not see the potential of telling this story from the very beginning? Especially when it's a story that hasn't even been told before in a meaningful way like this. Like, it's not a story that we all know, okay? We need to be told from the very beginning the story of the black samurai. But yes, instead of following Yasuke's story from when he landed in Japan for the very first time and was seen as this huge novelty, this big black man they'd never seen before, instead of telling that, we instead got this kind of Logan-esque story that we've seen time and time again within the anime genre as well, where he is tasked with taking care of this little kid who's the special, who's the one. Okay, we've seen so many of these stories is at this point, but she has special powers, and initially she's very sick, and that's because her powers are manifesting. But this person who's kind of her mother but not really her mother, I couldn't quite make out if she was her actual mother, but she was kind of her protector who managed to get her out of the clutches of this evil priest. That evil priest was crazy. And it kind of touched on the kind of attitude towards the Catholic Church at that time that Japanese people had, which was interesting, but it wasn't really touched on with any real depth, unfortunately. But yeah, the crazy priest who had that girl because he believed in some prophecy that she would have powers and blah blah blah, but she ended up being taken away by the singer, the town singer, who kind of went into the town pretending to be a singer in order to protect her until her powers started to manifest. And then they needed to find this doctor who's not really a doctor but rather a fellow samurai or a fellow kind of soldier who used to fight alongside Yasuke. And so it's all about their journey to kind of getting to that doctor so that she can figure out what's going on with her powers and perhaps be trained to use them. And that's what the story ends up being. And like, it's fine. It's fine. It could have been better. It could have been better if we were actually seeing something that we'd never seen before, which is the story unfold about a black samurai, but whatever. And like I said, it wasn't torture for me to watch this. Like, I still enjoyed the series overall. I also very much enjoyed the dynamics between some of the guns for hire, the kind of assassins who were sent to get the little girl so they can take her to the priest. I liked some of them. They were, you know, fun. There was this kind of robot who was part of this team for some inexplicable reason. Like, this is supposed to be set in like the 16th century, and like, there's this robot who's just there, and like, fine, like, it's anime, like, fine. I really would have preferred anything else. Like, I would have preferred him to be like, I don't know, like a talking animal, but I guess, you know, one of the other team members is already a bear. Like, she's a Russian female who turns into a bear. Like, how original. I especially liked the kind of, I guess he's like a witch doctor. I don't know who he is, but he's another black man. And I liked seeing them kind of bounce off of each other, you know, him and Yasuke, and kind of reflecting on their experiences as black men in Japan, seeing the kind of contrasts between them. Again, it's not explored on a very deep level, but it was interesting to see kind of hints of that being explored throughout the series that I enjoyed. And the thing is, even that would have been much more tolerable if it wasn't for the fact that the girl at the center of this story, because make no mistake, she ends up being at the center of this story, is so annoying. She is so annoying. It's like they dropped this kind of white girl from suburbia in America bang in the middle of a story that's supposed to take place in 16th century Japan for some inexplicable reason. She is so annoying. This kind of Haley Stacy girl who's randomly in this story, who says like and like has like vocal fry, is so annoying. I can't believe that's who they decided to be the main character for this series. You know, basically taking the limelight away from Yasuke himself, let's be real. But I can't believe she's the one that he has to protect. She's so annoying, especially at the beginning, where she's like, you have to take me to the doctor because you promised. It's like, sis, he just risked his life for you. He just saw your former guardian get killed over you, and you want him to take you to the doctor? How? What obligation does he have? And like, sure, by the end she becomes slightly less annoying, especially after she's saved Yasuke's life several times, but like, am I supposed to clap for her for doing the bare minimum? Because I'm not going to. Like, the only reason why he's in that situation in the first place is because of her, so I'm not going to clap for her for saving his life when literally that's the bare minimum that she could have done. So yeah, I really didn't like the little girl character. Okay, and it's so important that she came across as likable, because she is the one that he's trying to protect, and like, literally risking his life to protect, even though he has no connection to her initially. So it really was just so hard to buy into this story. And then again, as I keep mentioning, thinking of all of the other possibilities that we could have had if the story had focused on something far more interesting, like, say, the formation, the birth of a black samurai. And my final critique when it comes to this series was that I was surprised to see how Americanized it was, and slightly disappointed by that. Even though though it's incredible to see that Lakeith Stanfield ended up voicing the character of Yasuke, and I think he gives a great vocal performance here, I would have preferred if Yasuke actually had an African accent, considering that he's supposed to have come from, you know, Africa, from 16th century Africa. I think that would have been so cool. And I think, you know, incorporating some Afro beats, you know, some traditional African drums and music and sounds within the soundtrack of the show also would have been so cool. As it stands, it kind of has infusions of like funk, I guess, and like infusions of very, you know, American music, and it's still very much rooted in Black American culture and African American culture, but I would have preferred to see it lean more towards the Africa side of things, considering that he is an African samurai at the end of the day. Like, he's not just Black, but he came straight from the continent of Africa, and I would have liked to see that be reflected in the actual show. And again, I think, you know, LaShawn Thomas in that sense very much leaned more towards his American roots, his African American roots, when in reality I would have liked to see him try and delve into the African side of things to make this a fusion between Japanese and African culture, even though there's no such thing as African culture, but maybe even Mozambican culture to be specific. As it stands, I do think that this series did have a lot of missed opportunities when it comes to delving into the topic of a Black samurai. I mean, this is such a huge deal. I know that there was originally supposed to be this live action project surrounding a Black samurai who would have been portrayed by Chadwick Boseman. Like, can you imagine? Oh, but yeah, I hope that someone else picks up a project, a live action project about this incredible character, because I think we haven't even touched the surface of what can be explored here. But as it stands, I'm going to be giving the Netflix series Yasuke a 6.5 out of 10. So that's it from me. Now that I told you guys my thoughts on Yasuke, it's time for you guys to let me know what you thought of the series down in the comments below. Please be sure to subscribe to catch new videos coming up. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.